Ucypher, India's first multi-gaming, multi-platform esports championship. 6 teams of 14 players each compete across 4 games: Counter-Strike Global Offensive, Dota 2, Tekken 7, and Real Cricket 17. Each team faces the other team twice in the league stage, and 3 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Tekken 7 and Real Cricket 17 in each match. 5 points each are awarded to the winning teams of Dota 2 and CSGO games in a match. The top 4 teams in the league stage move to the knockout rounds. Ucypher, 6 teams, 84 cyber athletes, and a grand prize pool of 51 lakh rupees.
Welcome to Ucypher, naya sport, naye superstars. My name is Aisha, and we have reached day 26 of India's only multi-platform, multi-gaming, multiplayer esports championship. Today is the Sherdils versus the Akramaks. In dono ke pichle match mein Sherdils ne Akramaks ko buri tarah hara diya tha. They won by a 10-point margin, the scores being 13-3. So today is clearly going to be payback time for the Akramaks. And since we're now approaching the semis, our teams understand that every point is going to bring them closer to the knockout rounds.
Both the teams have given blood, sweat and passion to reach where they are today. So enough talking, let's play.
The Sherdils, the team that's at number 3 right now with 61 points. When you went up against the Akramaks, it was a 3-1 scenario, right? You only lost cricket. So I want to first talk to Aggressive. Where is my man?
He's sleeping.
Man, your team is performing super well right now and you gotta like pull through this time. So have you been practicing?
Yeah, I've been practicing for 2 days, like last 2 days. I'm mostly missing like Yorker balls.
Okay.
So that's why I'm practicing mostly on Yorker.
Right. But tell me, the last 2 CS games that you guys played, yeah? I remember talking to you about Falcon again and again because match ke beech mein tum dono ek dusre ke saath ladne lag jate ho.
Oh, ladne nahi rehte hum, but we were just talking like, okay, Baba, just stop it. Don't talk about the past rounds. Just talk about the future rounds. What are we going to do now? तो वो ही कम्युनिकेशन में मैं उसको बहस कर रहा था यार अभी बस कर प्लेयर प्रेशर में आ जाएंगे तो पिछले राउंड की बात मत कर आगे की राउंड की बात कर कि क्या करना है करके
Alright guys, the Sherdils are at number 3 with 71 points. Today is going to be quite amazing, but let's keep the peace going along with some aggression. Still looking at you, buddy.
Kappa, very important day for you. Today is your day where you can book a place in the semi-finals. Nervous हो, excited हो?
Excited हूँ कि जितना ही आज कुछ भी हो जाए. पिछली बार हम लोग ने mistake किया था CS:GO में. इस बार कुछ नहीं करेंगे.
CS:GO की बात करेंगे तो आपकी team consistently अच्छा perform कर रही है.
हाँ.
Manan is leading the entire championship in frags. 184. I mean that's not possible without a good team support.
वो तो best player है ही. लेकिन हम लोग का team भी best है. लेकिन उसका frags का खुराक बहुत ज़्यादा है.
All the best. All the best, Akramaks.
I hope you do well. Welcome to Match Day 26. Today we have an exciting matchup between the Sherdils and the Akramaks because the Sherdils are on 70 points, third position. The Akramaks at 61 in fourth. But let's not forget the Yodhas, hot on their heels with 58 points in fifth position. Anyone can be relegated now. In CS:GO, we have both the captains who are specialized in their game. CS:GO, Kappa versus Ritesh. The last time they met, the Akramaks lost. And even though the Akramaks are coming into this game with 4 wins back-to-back, it's going to be difficult to play the Sherdils because Ritesh and Kappa played together in the past. Right. So it's going to be a very lopsided game. Can go anywhere.
Well, round robin one face-off, mein Sherdils 13 points liye the jab wo Akramaks ko khele the. Right. So that's the reason today is a high chance of a whitewash by them.
Let's jump into Tekken 7 where we see Hans in action again.
Fun fact, hashtag trivia about Tekken 7. Did you know that Akuma is the only character from another franchise in Tekken 7? But this is no street fight. This is the real deal. This is Tekken 7. Players apne character select karenge. हर राउंड में जिसका एचपी खत्म हो जाएगा वो राउंड हार जाएगा। हर मैच एक रेस है 3 राउंड्स जीतने की, और जो प्लेयर पहले 3 मैचेस जीतेगा वो बनेगा टेकन 7 का विनर। लेट द बैटल बिगिन। With the way Hans has been performing, I think he should become a character himself in Tekken. But Shekhar,
yeah.
Have you been having any sleepless nights?
No.
At all? Hans?
I'm his worst nightmare.
All right, no sleep for the wicked. Players, let's begin Tekken 7.
Welcome back to another game of Tekken 7 between the Sherdils and the Akramaks. On Sherdils we have Hans, and on Akramaks we have Afro Ninja.
Round 1. Fight.
And the fight begins. A good clash between these two players. And now King being quite heavy for Alisa. She is low on HP and a huge advantage on King on his HP. Well, they miss both of their moves, and now Alisa going in for the pressure on King. Well, a nice comeback from King, and that is going to be a knockout for Alisa.
Round two.
Well, the round 2 begins, and Alisa with good moves on King. King going low on his HP and now applying some pressure on her. Well, she is low on her HP and she has the rage art. Both the players now have the rage art, but Alisa not giving any chance, and that's a knockout.
Fight.
Well, Alisa trying to play safe over here and knocks him off with the head. And this is not looking good for King right now, because he was going low but now applying pressure on Alisa. Well, Alisa now stuck into the corners, and well, she does have the rage art on her. Good blocks from her as well, a nice read, and the rage art does connect on King. So now King is going low on HP, so taking like a 50% damage already. And now Alisa would look like a comeback into the game. King just blocked her perfectly, and looks like the hit was... This hit is gonna be a knockout. King starting off good with the game, and Alisa with that move is gonna give some nice damage to King. Both of them on equal HP. And well, Alisa now with the rage art, well, the rage art does connect, and again, King is gonna take some huge damage from that. King now has the rage art on him, and now he is trying to punish off a good block from Alisa, and this looks like a knockout for King. So the Akramaks win the first match of best of 3, 3-1.
Round 1. Fight.
Round 2 begins, and King at the start just slams her head to the ground, and now Alisa is low on HP. Well, she has the rage art, and well, it doesn't connect because it was a good block from King. But still, Alisa trying really hard. And now it's gonna be a knockout.
Round 2. Fight.
Well, King going in for the combo, and now Alisa going back in the game, and nice block from King, but now she is on HP, and there is a knockout.
Round 3. Fight.
King not showing any mercy, and Alisa now it looks like a smash to the ground, and she is losing health on it. But it is a good comeback into the game. Alisa giving some nice damage on King. King with good blocks as well. And he removed her head, going for the move, but King going in for the combo. And now Alisa stuck into the corners. And did try to go for a range drive, but then she gets a knockout. So the Sherdils win match number 2, 3-0.
Round 1. Fight.
It looks like a character change coming in for the Akramaks. It's gonna be Kazumi, Akramaks' favorite character. Well, King now going into the game, applying some pressure on Kazumi. Kazumi going low on health, now has the rage out and stuck into the corners as well. And King with the last hit is gonna knock her out.
Fight.
Kazumi tried for an uppercut, but it was blocked from King. King doing some nice blocks over here, and a good clash between these two players. And now Kazumi going low on HP, and that hit is gonna throw her off the map. And now a good slam to Kazumi on the ground, and the last hit is gonna knock her off.
Round 3. Fight.
Well, King grabs her by her arm and going for the first smash and the second one.
And looks like it's for the third one as well. A nice move from King. Kazumi low on her HP. King has not taken a single damage right now, and it's gonna end up perfect. Sherdils win match number 3-0.
Round 1. Fight.
King now trying to maintain the distance from Kazumi. And now back into the game, slams Kazumi onto the ground, and she's stuck into the corners. King again going with that move, which is gonna break her joints. Well, Kazumi now has the rage art on her, and King with a huge HP lead. Well, King is now maintaining distance and going in for the fight. Kazumi stuck into the corners, and it's gonna be a knockout. It's gonna be a knockout. King going in for the combo and ends it with nice slam to the ground on Kazumi. Well, now King has taken a little bit of damage and going for the move. Amazing move from King. Well, Kazumi a hit away from Rage Art. Well, now she has the Rage Art and the second move as well. He's going for the third one, leaving Kazumi on low HP. Well, he ends the misery on the aftermarks.
Round 3. Fight.
Well, good read to the game from King. He is actually giving some serious damage on Kazumi. And he noticed that she is not blocking towards mid and low, and now going for that fight. Well, now King is low on the tree, and finally we see the lunging tiger from Kazumi. Well, she now has the Rage Art on her, and the lunging tiger comes out on time. Well, King is also low on HP. Both of them have the Rage Art. Kazumi pulls the Rage Drive, but blocked from King. And now Kazumi is gonna get a knockout, and the Sherdils win the game.
Of course you won. How many of those new combos did we see of King today?
King is a grab player, so these were his signature moves. So he has more than 192 moves in
what?
The list. Yep. And
And you remember all of them?
99% at least.
Ritz, the next match is Real Cricket 17. And we know that aggressive needs a lot to learn from Hans over here and pull through his team. So let's see how this pans out now.
The game of cricket was actually invented in England, but the maximum number of people playing it are Indians. It's a religion. It's a lifestyle. So how can an esports championship be complete without a game like this? It's time for Real Cricket 17.
Ye ek batting only match hai. हर प्लेयर एक ओवर फेस करेगा जिसमें उसे मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने होंगे मैक्सिमम रन्स बनाने वाला प्लेयर मैच जीत जाएगा टाई होने पर दोनों प्लेयर्स एक सुपर ओवर खेलेंगे टू डिसाइड द विनर
विद मी आई हैव लव एसएक्स एंड एग्रेसिव हु आर ऑल सेट टू प्ले गेम नंबर 2 सागर आपका यूसाइफर में सेकंड हाईएस्ट स्कोर है 239 रन्स और आज फर्स्ट आने के लिए यू नीड ओनली 17 रन्स So, are you aiming at only 17 or 36?
No, I told you before that I don't have anything. I just want to win this match. Hans has
already won. One victory, you beat Sagar Vyas. I mean, you will be written in your books. I'm not joking. Okay? Time for the toss. Who will call?
Tails.
Tails it is.
First batting.
First batting. तो सागर को आप प्रेशर में डालने वाले हो।
हाँ।
Come on, Sherdils. All the best. We'll be batting first. All the best. आप चेस करेंगे।
Welcome back to Real Cricket 17. Now it's gonna be the game between the Sherdils and the Akramaks. It's going to be Anup, aka Aggressive, from the Sherdils to bat first. And a huge hit towards the boundary, and it's a 6. And the second ball. A good hit from him, but now it's gonna go for a four. Third ball of the over. Again, a whack towards the boundary. It's going for a six. So 16 runs, three balls. And looks like it's gonna go huge. It's a six. Second last ball of the over. And he misses it. This is the last ball of the over. And that is flying towards the boundary, and still it's gonna go for a four.
So Akramaks now need 27 runs in six balls to win this game.
So it's gonna be Sagar Vyas, aka Love SX, from the Akramaks to bat next. And that's a huge hit, but still with a one bounce, it's gonna go for a four. Second ball comes in. Again, it's a nice hit, but again, it's going for a four. Third ball of the over. And looks like it's going for a six. And that ball comes in. And it's an LBW, so he is out. So they need two sixes to win this game. And that's a huge hit. It is going for a six. It's a last ball of the over, and they need a six to win this game. And he is out. So the Sherdils win the game.
I told you that in history, your name will be written in the history. What a game! What a game!
Captain Kam Sim ये नहीं बोलेगा लंगड़ा घोड़ा चल गया।
मैं वाला दौड़ गया अभी। Okay.
Sherdils are at six and the Akramaks at zero and aggressive, just threw the ball out of the court. In our next game, you may have the best weapons, the best shooters, and the best aim, but unless your team plays like a unit, you cannot win a single round of CS:GO.
इस गेम में दो टीम्स होती हैं, एक टेररिस्ट टीम और दूसरी काउंटर टेररिस्ट टीम। ये एक टीम बेस्ड गेम है जो 5 वर्सेस 5 के फॉर्मेट पर खेले जाएगी। प्लेयर्स कौन से मैप पे खेलेंगे वो एक बैनिंग प्रोसेस से तय होगा। शुरुआत में दोनों टीम्स को $800 की गेम करेंसी मिलती है। The aim of the terrorist team is to plant the bomb and secure it or kill all the counter-terrorists. The aim of the counter-terrorist team is to either defuse the bomb or kill all the terrorists. इस मैच में 30 rounds होंगे and the first team to win 16 rounds is the game winner. In the case of a tie, the final result will be decided with a race to 4 wins.
Boys and girls, today must be a very special day because I am going to witness, along with you guys, the map veto for CS:GO. In this process, Kappa has already chosen to pick first, which means that Ritz will be banning first. There are a total number of how many maps?
Seven
maps. And you will ban first, which means at the end, you will be picking out of the two. Okay, let's begin.
Yeah, sure. I'll ban Inferno.
Inferno is banned.
Train ban.
Train is banned.
Cobble ban.
Nuke ban.
Ritz, you will be banning the last one.
Yeah, I'll ban Mirage.
Mirage. That leaves us with two maps. Which are they?
Overpass and Cash.
And you are choosing?
Cash.
Cash. So Cash it is. Today we are going to be watching these two awesome teams go at each other at the Cash map. Okay guys, back to your teams.
Thank you.
Good luck. All the best.
Welcome back to another game of Counter-Strike between the Sherdils and the Akramaks. So now it's gonna be the knife round, and as you know, the winner of the knife round will get to choose the side. So D as in terrorist and CT as in counter-terrorist. So the players have assembled towards mid and now the fight begins. Buster getting a frag on mid and Freaky getting the last frag. So the Sherdils have won the knife round and they choose to play as Tees first. Looks like a setup from the Sherdils is rushing towards B and Manan gets a one tap on Buster and now going for the second frag, but Kappa is there to tag team him over there and Manan going for the second frag, but he goes down by Slots. Now it's a 2-on-4 situation. Slots struggling with his accuracy towards the long haul and now finds one frag, going for the second one, but Kappa erases him off.
Hey, be short, Taro.
And now Falcon waiting towards the middle. Well, he finds a player is going to middle, but he shouldn't have killed him and waited. But no, he goes down instantly. A good raid from the Akramaks. So the Akramaks winning 4 rounds back to back. And the Sherdils now just made a comeback into the game. So now let's jump into round number 6. Falcon with a good nade towards the entrance of the warehouse. S01's giving a boost to his player. Now Falcon moving into the corners, Mithil holding with his SMG on towards the box. Looks like SMX has found a player, but Falcon is gonna shut him down. Manan waiting and spotting towards the highway and Freaky finds his head and shuts him down. Falcon with a good kill on Mithil as well. I don't know how he knew that thing he was waiting over there, and Kappa coming in for a retreat over here. Now it's a 2-on-4 situation. And Slots planting the C4 onto the bombsite B. It's going to be a tough one for the Akramaks to make a comeback in this round. But nothing is impossible for them. But Reigns is going to shut Kappa down with his AWP. And now Badman stuck in a 1-on-4 situation. The players are rushing towards him. He finds one frag. And there he goes with a pop flash. But he goes down instantly by Slots. Kappa playing aggressive, he finds one frag and tags the another one, and Badman over here getting 2 instant kills over here, and now amazing play from Badman. Well, he is waiting and now he finds one more player, that's gonna be Ridge, the captain of the team, going down for the Sherdils. Now it's all on Buster, a 1-on-3 situation, the last man standing for the Sherdils. A good Mori just to block off the player to enter from the heavens. Well, now he gave his pose that he is holding over here and Manan rushes in and gets his head.
Both the teams are going neck to neck. The score is 7-all. And now let's jump into round number 15.
This is the last round of the first half. Manan pushing in through the smoke. Slots was ready with a shot over there and Manan goes down instantly. SMX again playing aggressive and Freaky again going down. Looks just like a replay over there. Rich with a good angle for the smoke and looks like he's gonna block the entrance. And Rich moving towards mid and what a single tap to Mithil. Mithil goes down and the players are pushing towards highway. SMX on the side gets Rich and then he just got traded from Slots. Now Slots low on HP through the smoke. He finds a frag and now Kappa goes down. So Badman left in a 1v3 situation and then he shuts Slots down. Well, he is low on HP. That is actually gonna be bad for him. Just 15 HP left on him. Badman now pushing onto the side. Doesn't have any perfect angle and he goes down by Buster. So 8-7 the first half. Looks like the game is going neck to neck and tough fight between these two teams. So now the teams would switch the sides and now the Akramaks are playing as Tees and the Sherdils as CTs. A very passive game at the start and now SMX holding an angle waiting for a push from the Sherdils to come in and well he finds Ritz who was pushing aggressive and Falcon with a nice one tap on SMX. SMX goes down Mithil with a good reflex on towards the vent room. He finds a frag on Falcon. Buster waiting onto the side. What a single tap given to Manan. Well, Manan goes down. Now a 3v3 situation. Buster struggling with his bullets. He goes down. And now Mithil getting 2 easy frags. And Mithil killing the last guy as well. So quad kill coming in for Mithil. So Akramaks playing really, really good. And the Sherdils are also giving them a tough fight. So let's jump into round number 20. Falcon holding an angle towards Amen, sprays and prays over there but gets one frag only. and now instantly trade over there. The Akramaks are on an eco. The economy for them has been destroyed from the Sherdils. But looks like they have the C4 plan now. And with it, through the smoke, gets a frag on Freaky, making it a 4v3. Well, Ritz has invested on an auto sniper over here. Mithil getting one more frag on Slots and Buster going in for frag, and Mithil goes down. Manan with a good angle over here with a deck line gets down Buster. Ritz with his auto sniper on this close range, not looking good for him. Kappa entering from the warehouse and shutting down Ritz. Kappa, he snatched the auto sniper. Ezra gonna make a good use of it, getting down Buster. And now SMX entering to the side. He gets on frag but gets instantly traded from Ritz. And Mithil over here, a good trade from him as well. Now it's gonna be Slots in a 1v4 situation, and he goes down as well. So the Akramaks need one round for the match point, and the Sherdils are now making a comeback into the game. So let's jump into round number 27. Buster pushing in towards mid. Manan getting a whoosh on the roof, and Buster killing him instantly. And SMX pushing through that smoke, he goes on as well, but Mithil with a nice straight frag on towards mid. Well, Freaky with a nice pop flash going in just for a jiggle peek and finds Mithil. He pops his head off instantly. And now it's gonna be a 2-on-4 situation. Kappa pushing in towards the B entrance from the long haul. Well, he finds Falcon. Ritz with a nice posing and gets two instant kills on the Akramaks. Ritz getting that boost, he spots the shoulder of SMX, and SMX goes down. A nice boost for the captain from the players, and now Freaky holding here. He is now gonna shut down Ritz, and now making it a 4v4 situation. Slot just managed to get one frag, but get instantly traded from Kappa. And Falcon coming in from the heavens, he finds Kappa. So a nice trade going on to the side. Now it's gonna be a 2-on-2 situation. And the Sherdils have to win this round just to make this game go for an overtime. Now it's gonna be Manan in a 1-on-3 situation. Well, he finds Mithil, and Falcon shutting Manan down. So now it's time for overtime. So all the rounds that I've played would not count right now, and the players will have to play 6 rounds again. Well, the overtime begins, and now Freaky holding towards mid, Kappa towards the event room. And now Freaky is gonna erase off Kappa. And Ritz holding onto the side in a nice cozy, but Warren finds him and he goes down. So now it's a 4-on-4 situation. SMX onto the side, a good molly from him towards the heavens finds a frag, and Freaky goes down, and Manan towards the corners of the side planting the C4 in a 4-on-3 situation. And the Sherdils now saving their weapons onto the city base. And the players are entering, and they're not gonna let them save their weapons. So the Akramaks win the round. Well, Buster playing aggressive towards the B entrance, a good molly from him. Buster entering to the vent room. Well, he finds Batman, and an instant trade coming over here from Kappa. Well, Mithil is going through the smoke. What timing between Mithil and Slots? And Kappa getting a nice shot on Ritz. So Ritz goes down. Freaky moving on to the bombsite A, and he goes down as well. And now it's Falcon in a 1-on-3 situation, has entered towards Forklift, and SMX has no info that he has entered. Kappa with a shot from the highway gets down Falcon. Batman holding towards the headshot pose, he finds a frag on Slots. And now Buster getting a nice spray over here on Manan. Manan goes down. Mithil coming in from Ventroom, he finds a frag. So it's raining frags everywhere in a 2-on-3 situation. Now Batman and Kappa left for the Akramaks. Well, Kappa making a huge sound for that rotation, and Ritz is gonna shut him down. Well, Batman alone left in a 1-on-2 situation right now. He is low on HP. Well, he is still going for the round because it's very important for them, and it's gonna be the last round. So now it's gonna go for another overtime as well. So more 6 rounds in this game. Freaky holding towards Forklift. SMX rushing from the blue doors. He finds a frag. But before closing the door, Falcon is closing his destiny right now. Falcon moving in aggressive, and he finds Manan, and Manan goes down, taking down a headshot, but Falcon took a huge damage as well. Kappa with a good smoke onto the side, and that is actually gonna block off the vision for the truck.
मेरे को पता है वस्टर ऐसा प्लेयर के उसने अगर दो प्लेयर को मारा है तो कंटिन्यूस तीसरे को भी मारने के लिए आएगा ही आएगा. खुजली है, खुजाने वाला है. तो मैं ऊपर चढ़ के एडवांटेज लेके उसका सर दिखा मेरे को, एडी कर रहा था. मैंने दो बुलेट छोड़े, हेडशॉट लगा और जंप मारते मारते मेरे को लास्ट प्लेयर स्पॉट हुआ, वो था रितेश, और सीधा उसके ऊपर शॉट लिया और उसको दो बुलेट में मार दिया.
एंड कपा विद अ क्वाड किल एंड द आक्रमाक्स हैव वन द गेम.
For the first time ever on Ucypher, we went into not one, but two OTs. Akramaks, congratulations. You guys won 22-19. I never thought I'd have to say a score for CSGO in such magnifications. But with a total of 219 total frags, Mithil left today, made 44, including in the OT, and he was clearly the MVP. आपने उसको क्या पेप टॉक दिया था आज?
कुछ नहीं, जो हमेशा ही करते हैं, बेसिक खेलना और एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी कुछ नहीं करने है.
It's what happened, dude. You guys were playing so well. Itna neck-to-neck game tha that we had to go into two overtimes. Our cameras and our experts got in the middle that Falcon was insulting and abusing your teammates itself.
That's a typical Falcon, you can call.
Really?
Yeah.
क्यों?
बस वो भड़कता है, ठीक है, हम ignore करते करके, but call जो कर रहा है वो अच्छा करता है.
This was quite an epic victory and an epic game in itself. Congratulations. Congratulations. It was a good game.
Welcome back to Ucypher Naya Sport, Naya Superstars. The last game of CSGO was the most exciting, the most fierce, the most longest battle we have ever witnessed of CSGO in Ucypher. But now it's time for the decider. It's time for a game that involves heroes, magic and a lot of planning. It's time for Dota 2.
डोटा 2 में हर प्लेयर अपने लिए एक हीरो सिलेक्ट करेंगे. इस गेम में दो टीम्स कम्पीट करेंगी इन अ 5v5 फॉर्मेट. हर हीरो के पास स्पेशल पावर्स और एबिलिटीज होती हैं. हर टीम का ऑब्जेक्टिव है अपने एंशंट्स को डिफेंड करना और अपने ओपोनेंट के सारे टावर्स को डिस्ट्रॉय कर देना. जो टीम पहले एनिमी टीम के डिफेंस को तोड़कर उनके सारे टावर्स डिस्ट्रॉय कर देगी वो टीम जीतेगी.
So with me, I have captains of both the teams, but they look quite exhausted after that intense game of CSGO. So I would give you guys a rest. आपके players से बात करते हैं, Opa and Brew Frog. Opa, आप काफी vocal gamer हो. जब आप gaming करते हो, तो आप काफी ज़्यादा बातें करते हो. और आपस में नहीं, against the team.
Provoke करूँगा तभी गलती करेंगे वो लोग. और गलती करेंगे तो तभी तो जीतेंगे.
तो कभी effect हुआ?
इतना इफेक्ट नहीं होता, लेकिन गेम है तो हंसी मजाक लेके फिर
वो मजाक तो बिल्कुल नहीं होता, ना हंसी होती है.
लेकिन हारेंगे नहीं, इतना गारंटी है, बिकॉज सब अपना स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉइंट्स खेलने वाले हैं, सब अपना पोजीशंस एंड ऑल. सब कल हम लोग ने जो प्रैक्टिस किया है उसमें सब प्रिपेयर करके आया है, जो भी होगा काउंटर पिकिंग एंड ऑल जो भी होगा वो. तो मोस्ट प्रोबेबली हारने नहीं वाले.
कप्पा, आप तो सच बोलते हैं, आप बताइए.
प्रैक्टिस करना वो लोग का काम है, खेलना भी वो लोग का काम है. लेकिन अगर ट्रिगर हो गए ओपा चिल्लाने के बाद तो श्योर शॉट हार जाएंगे. अगर वो कंट्रोल करके खेल लेंगे, अपना गेम खेलेंगे तो जीत सकते हैं.
अरे काफ़ी कॉन्फिडेंट लग रहे हो आप लोग. ऑल द बेस्ट.
थैंक यू.
We'll be right back.
Good evening, folks, and welcome back to Ucypher Season 1, where we've got the Akramaks on the Dire facing off versus the Sherdils on the Radiant. Off the bat, an arrow makes a clean connection under disruption. The telekinesis is there. They throw him back. He's looking to TP, but three heroes pound away on him and secure first blood.
Meanwhile, Dream farming up the jungle. Disruption sees him, misses with the cogs, throws him back, gets slowed up by the Venomous Gale himself, and now the Plague Wards adding on with the slows. Disruption suffering a slow and painful death here at the hands of Dream's Venomancer. He's gonna get saved for now by Opa with that cold embrace from the Winter Wyvern, but Disruption doesn't look like he's gonna get away. Maybe these cogs will help him get out after all. Here's the follow-up coming out. Mama Sita jumps in along with the Anti-Mage. They've done a fair amount of work and they will bring down Dream.
Mid lane, you got the disruption coming up from Great Defenders close to there. Three heroes pounding away on each other. The Sonic Wave missed time, but they get the kill on Great Blue Frog. With the Sonic Wave stolen, doesn't find anything in response, but here comes Disruption. Hookshot onto Make Believe. Make Believe still has the lead, gets away, turns around, drops an arrow. Akramaks, do they really want to go for this fight? From the side though, Mama Sita looping in with an arcane rune. He's got the dagger, has the screen, blinks forward, looks for it, Make Believe pops the moonlight shadow, but the damage over time will secure the kill. Akramaks, they seem absolutely out of sorts. They're not even finding trades in these team fights. Just as I say that though, they find Opa, who turns around, drops the Winter's Curse. Kiko needs to be careful. He's looking for the initiation. Rivals here, blinks forward aggressively. The Poison Nova's there. Dream survives for the time being, but Blue Frog ends up going down. Rival chasing for more, the parish is there. I don't think Akramaks can find this kill, and with the Guardian Angel, they'd possibly be denied even the Anti-Mage, but the Demonic Purge will just do enough damage to take away the Aegis.
Almost suicidal there from the Anti-Mage, if not for the Aegis, that does allow him to get back out and start beating up on the tier 3 tower. But I think because of those shenanigans, they can only take the tier 3 and make a back for it. Rival, being kept alive for now, has that cold embrace to survive through the onslaught coming out from Akramaks. Disruption coming in, trying to find a kill. Catches Dream in the cogs, along with a hook shot coming in. Now he's gone on to Dream. There's Rival getting the kill. He's on a mega kill streak now, and they've even got the tier 3 tower.
Kiko undercover, Moonlight Shadow hasn't gotten too much done, but just as I say that, he pops the dodge and he wants disruption, but once again the Winter's Curse will control him, and here comes Mama Sita. They bring down the Rubik first with the purification. Grave just walking ahead fearlessly. He's got to be careful. Mama Sita blinks forward, Disruption whiffs on the hook shot, but they can still chase for the Shadow Demon, and Grave will just end up falling. The Storm Hammer's there, the Poison Nova as well, but where's the follow-up? Hans pops the Guardian Angel, hopes to keep them healthy, and Mama Sita just chases for more. He's got the Repel upon him. He'll unload the Sonic Wave, and with the Soul Word from the Orchid, they'll get that kill.
Now Kiko trapped up in the cogs. I think this is the looks of the eyes of a man who's just given up on life now. There's the Mana Void, a big one at that. Three heroes herded into the fountain and being brought down in there as well. Even Grave goes down just outside. Rival, however, stunned up, but it's too little too late. They'll tap out. The GG well played comes out. And it looks like Sherdils will take the win here versus the Akramaks.
And Sherdils just being the better side by a mile today.
Ucypher ka samse fastest game hai bhaiyo, fastest. 23.16 minutes.
Draw versus the Marksman in round 3, but round 4 brings better news for the Sherdils, a win here versus the Akramaks. Now, you beat them at CS 16-6, if I remember correctly, in your previous encounter. Sadly, this one didn't go your way, but the overall leg did. You won Tekken, which, as always, Hans just absolutely nailed. That's done. You won Cricket, which was a really good one for you.
It was a surprise. I mean, Sagar Vyas ke samne wo jeeta, jo I think Sagar Vyas pehla banda tha Ucypher mein jo 6 chakke mare. Uske samne jeeta, I think Anup ko bhi bharosa nahi ho raha tha. Bhai, mere ko hosh mein le gaya. Main hi haraya hu Sagar ko. Theek hai.
Fir CS mein, I think it was really close, right?
CS, I think hum log mid games hi haar jaate hain, but hum log ne bahut hi acha comeback kiya. Over time mein haare बहुत बुरा लग रहा है ओवर टाइम में भी नहीं आना चाहिए था वो पहले ही खत्म कर देना चाहिए था
वेल इन द एंड अ 3-1 विन फॉर दीस गाइस व्हिच इज अ बिग बिग
reason to smile. I know CS is the one you want to smile about the most, but...
Just one whitewash.
Exactly.
I need one whitewash.
As team captain, I think a win in the bag, and I think that's most crucial. So this is a big positive going forward again for the Sherdils.
And that wraps up day 26 of our championship. Nobody could have predicted what all happened today. To begin with, Afro Ninja took a set of hunts in Tekken 7.
He played well.
Yeah,
fairly well.
All right. But Aggressive won against Sagar.
That was a shocker.
And we saw the longest game of CSGO on Ucypher so far with 2 overtimes. And on the other hand, our game of Dota 2 was super quick.
Yeah, I mean, Sherdils went hard at the Akramaks.
And the Akramaks couldn't come back.
Yeah.
Well, I have to say they both fought very bravely, but the winner today is Team Sherdils with 11 points and the Akramaks have 5. At the end of today's gameplay, this is what the leaderboard looks like.
To watch this entire winning gameplay, you can log on to usports.in and we'll be seeing you guys tomorrow for yet another epic matchup between the Yodhas and the Marksmen only on Ucypher Naya Sport, Naya Superstars, a Usports initiative. My name is Varun.
And I'm Aisha.
Do Ucypher.
मैं उनमें दो लंबे लोग हैं ना वैनम और सिद्धेश
हाँ
तो यही बोलना चाहूँगा जितनी उनकी हाइट है उतनी उनकी टाइट है आज
चाहे सामने कोई भी टीम आए डोटा तो नहीं हारने वाला